7% by the end of the year. Jim Chalmers says there will be cost of living relief in his October budget, and pressure will mount on the government to extend the cut to petrol excise.
Australia's cost of living crisis is set to deepen.
It means I got to save more money, I got to make more money, and I just got to work more and save up more, and I can't keep up half the time.
As the Treasurer prepares the nation for more hip pocket pain.
Inflation will be significantly higher than what was expected in the last government's most recent budget. The Reserve Bank has said something around 7%. That doesn't seem to me to be wildly off the mark.
The price of food going up is just becoming ridiculous, but we have to live, so we have to do it.
Jim Chalmers will deliver his first budget on October 25 and is promising some relief from rising prices.
There'll be a cost of living package.
Economists warn that more government spending will feed a spiral that pushes up prices and interest rates.
That means it costs the budget, which tips money back into the economy, which simply adds to inflation and makes the Reserve Bank go harder.
But the Treasurer will be under intense pressure to extend the previous government's temporary halving of petrol excise, because if he doesn't, there will be a rude shock for drivers.
Prices will jump at the pump 24 cents a litre. Come late September.
I can see it going up to about $2.50 a litre.
All this makes it hard to deliver on Labor's aim to push up wages faster than living costs.
We hope that inflation will begin to moderate next year. That's our expectation. It's the Reserve Bank's expectation as well. Our job in our economic plan and in our budget is to get wages growing in a sustainable way so that we can get that real wages growth.
And with businesses struggling to find staff, the opposition wants pensioners and veterans to be able to double the number of hours they work before their benefits are cut.
Those who want to work and do an extra day or two, for them to be able to work and for it not to affect their pension.
The government isn't opposed to the idea, but it would come at a cost to the budget.
Even an idea like this, which appears to be relatively modest, still comes with a relatively hefty price tag.
Treasury estimates that the cost is about $112 million a year.
But every penny counts for a Treasurer preparing a budget already bleeding red ink. Chris Yeoman, Nine News.